I have a DJI Phantom. I have the first generation version. That's the one that you can mount a GoPro to and you can take HD video. It's got about 15 minutes of flight time and you can fly around and have a good time with it.
These days, drones seem to be everywhere.
They might seem fun at first, but when you hear stories about drones crashing into the side of buildings, you might be wondering, are they safe?
I mean, I think it really depends on the operator and someone's experience.
As an avid UAV builder, Cohen customized his quadcopter and linked it to a computer on wheels.
When you come around the side of a building, you know this from walking on the street, the wind direction can change very suddenly, and it can be a big gust, and at altitude, even more so.
I think there's a good balance that can be struck between safe use and being able to keep the hobby alive.
Most drones do have safety features built in. If an RC or GPS signal is lost, causing the drone to go MIA, or if the battery gets low, the fail-safe mode kicks in and sends the drone home autonomously. Buried inside, electrical speed controllers link the motor to the power source. This ensures that the motor doesn't burn out. And to improve the drone's durability, DIY drone enthusiasts are even experimenting with 3D printed hybrid materials.
It's a filament made of a mixture of PLA and carbon fibers. So it's very stiff. It's easy to work with.
With all of these design improvements, maybe Amazon delivery drones could be a real possibility.
In a densely populated area, it's not all that feasible, although from a logistics standpoint, if you had a fulfillment center, you know, two blocks away and you had a radius that you were going to deliver within, it's actually very feasible.
This means that in the near future, there might be more drones lurking in the midst.
For Scientific American, I'm Theresa Chong.